In this video, we are going to learn about set associative mapping. In the case of set associative mapping, the formula is main memory block address mod number of sets in the cache. The complete blocks in the cache is divided into number of sets, and which is nothing but number of blocks we'll be having in a set. So 12th block we want to bring into the cache, and which is of 4 sets. So 12 mod 4 is equal to 0, means set 0. So in set 0 we are having block 0 and block 1. We can place it anywhere if both are free. And suppose if I say like block 1 is occupied, we can place in block 0. If block 0 is occupied, we can place in block 1. Suppose if both are free, we are going to choose randomly in set 0. K-way set associative mapping means how many blocks are there in one set is nothing but k-way, indicates there are k blocks in a set. So here cache is going to be organized as sets, each is having k blocks. The main memory address is divided into 3 blocks here, that is tag, set and word. First, set bits, that is this d bits, will be used to identify the set. So set 0 or set 1, set 2, like this. So in this case we are identifying the set 1, and all the tags in this set 1 will be used to compare with the tag in the given memory address. So once if the tag is matched, the corresponding tag will be considered and W bits will be considered to identify the word in that particular block. If no match is occurring, then we say it as a cache miss and search will be taken in main memory. This is the way we say as k-way set associative mapping. And here k is nothing but we say as the number of blocks in a set. Set associative mapping, the same what we have discussed using the figure is explained here. Each word of cache can store 2 or more words of memory under the same index address. So because here we'll be having the same index, but more number of words can be stored in this. The comparison logic is done by an associative search of the tags in the set, similar to an associative memory search, thus the name set associative. Once we identify the set, it behaves as a fully associative mapping. So the comparison logic, what we are following in the fully associative mapping, is similar to this particular comparison logic. Hit ratio increases as the set size increases, but more complex comparison logic is required when number of bits in words of the cache increases. When we are increasing the set size, obviously it will be almost equal to the fully associative mapping. So maybe we might get a slight hit ratio in the case of fully associative mapping, in the case of set associative mapping, but the comparison logic becomes complex in that case. So that is the reason why we go for set associative mapping. When a miss occurs and the set is full, one of the tag data items are replaced using block replacement policy. So when we want to bring some particular block from main memory to the cache memory, and if the corresponding set is full, then a particular tag data item will be replaced and this particular block will be identified using block replacement policy. These are the formulas which help us to identify the tag, set and word fields in the main memory address. Let us consider a particular problem. A set associative cache memory consists of 64 lines or slots divided into 4 line sets. Main memory consists of 4 blocks of 128 words each. Show the format of the main memory address. Means we are supposed to identify the number of bits in the tag field. We are supposed to identify the number of bits in the set field and the word field. First, let us draw the figure so that it will be clear for us how to identify these. So the figure goes like this. If you see, this is a cache memory organization. If you see here, we are telling 64 lines or slots. So complete lines is 64 here, 0 to 63, divided into 4 line sets. Means in each sets 4 lines will be there. So line 0, 1, 2, 3 comes under set 0. Similarly 4, 5, 6, 7 goes with set 1. And last 4, 60, 61, 62, 63 goes for set 15. So if you see, like 64 by 4 is nothing but 16. So we say 16 sets. And each block have 128 words each. 4K blocks are there in main memory. And each block is having 128 words. So the block size in main memory and cache memory will be same. So here we are giving block size as 0 to 127 words. That is 128 words in each block. Block and line are same. So total number of blocks is given as 64. Number of blocks in each set is 4. So total number of sets is equal to total number of blocks by number of blocks in each set is equal to 64 by 4 is equal to 16, which is nothing but 2 power d, implies d equal to 4. Block size is equal to 2 power w. So block size here is 128 words. So 2 power w is 128, which implies w is equal to 7. We got the number of sets and number of words in each block, means number of bits in the set field, number of bits in the word field. And then 2 power s plus w is equal to 4k into 128. Here 4k blocks are there and 128 words in each block is there. So this is like number of words only, we didn't consider the word size. So the number of words in main memory is 4k into 128, that is 2 power 19. So total main memory address size is 19. So s is equal to 19 minus w, that is 19 minus 7, that is equal to 12. So tag is equal to s minus d, that is equal to 12 minus 4 is equal to 8. This solution is given according to the formulas what we have seen in the previous slide. So the other way is nothing but here we identified the number of bits in a set and number of bits in the word field. Now we know that the main memory address size is 19. So 19 minus 7 minus 4 is nothing but 8, which is nothing but the tag field bits. In this way we can identify the number of bits in the tag, set and word fields. Let us solve one more problem in this. A two-way set associative cache has lines of 16 bytes and the total size of 8k bytes. The 16 megabyte main memory is byte addressable. Show the format of main memory addresses. So here let us go with the diagram again. So here we say that it is a two-way set associative cache. Means there are two blocks in each set and has lines of 16 bytes. Means we are having 16 bytes in each line and a total of 8k bytes. So here the size of cache memory is 8k bytes and here each block is having 16 bytes and each set is having two lines. So the same thing we have represented in the form of figure. So in this fashion we will be getting the number of sets as 256. The main memory address size is 64 mega. Mega means 2 power 20. 64 means 2 power 6. So main memory address size goes with 26 bits. So let us solve this one by one. Number of words in a line is 16 given in the question. So w is equal to 4. Total cache size is 8k bytes. Number of lines in a cache is 8k by 16, that is 512. So here 8k is the total size and number of bytes in a line is given as 16. So 8k by 16 give you 512, that is 512 blocks are there. Number of lines in a set is 2. So, number of sets is 512 by 2. That is 256. So, we say that D is equal to 8. Then, main memory address is 26, 64 megabytes. That is 26 will be the main memory address size. So, tag will be 26 minus 8 minus 4. So, we get 14. 26 minus 8 is 18. 18 minus 4 is 14. So, tag will be 14 bits. Thank you.